So, good evening, everybody. My name is Amit Barve, and I represent Enerpac Energy. All of you must be wondering what this Breaking 2 is. Is anybody aware about what the Breaking 2 project was? No? Okay, fine. So, running is my second passion beyond solar. Solar is definitely the first passion. And that's the reason I follow this sport. And Breaking 2 was a project which was conceived by a sports apparel company, Nike. The aim of this project was to break a 2 hours barrier, and that was the reason it was called as a Breaking 2. Running 42 kilometers, a full marathon, within a time frame of 2 hours, that's the project which was conceived. The world record as of now is of 2 hours and 2 minutes to run a 42 kilometers, and no athletes have been unable to break this record for long years, and that's the reason this company took over this challenge of breaking this record by putting certain special efforts. The event was done on 5th of May in a place called as Monza in Italy, which is a racing track actually, which was used to do this feat. Now, all of you must be wondering for last 2 to 3 minutes, what does Breaking 2 has a relevance with the solar sector actually, yeah? We are here for a solar conference, and what does it resemble? So, just to remind all of us, we are also having a Breaking 2 challenge, which we already have taken. But Breaking 2 into 50 gigawatt, that is 100 gigawatt of a target, as a part of a national solar mission that we want to achieve. This is the target which got revised after the new government came, and things have started moving ahead. And today I'll just briefly say what is the progress, what are the bottlenecks, and how the things are happening in this program. This was the actual photograph of the event. You can see there was a vehicle which was leading all the athletes who were running to showcase the timing and pace at which they are running. You can also see a laser-guided triangle, which was like if an athlete is running within that triangle at that pace, he is likely to finish the race within less than 2 hours. But you will be surprised, the number of people who are running, they were all not competing. Many of the people who are in the black t-shirt were the pacers actually, not the actual runners. And they were just leading the actual runners to catch up onto the pace for the entire running. And they were actually moving out every 10th of kilometer, and new pacers were coming again with a full energy, running at a fast pace to take the leading race. So that was the arrangement. My point here is that today we have a target of 20 gigawatt. We have to have a pace, we have to have a consistency. Today what is happening is the project tenders are not happening in the phase which have been planned. The pace is not getting maintained. The frequency of RFQs coming out is really invariable, which is actually leading the project developers to become restless. They have got so many people on the board, they have a huge targets which they have committed to their investors. And if the tenders don't come, as and when come, there is a huge aggression, which is leading to basically a very low tariff, which will also become an eventually a problem, executing such projects at a level where you can maintain the quality. And ultimately, if you do not maintain the quality, the life itself may not be 25 years. We have seen ample examples, what Shoma already shown us. And the confidence in the entire sector will start derailing if the sites don't perform to the expectation. So the point what I wanted to drive here is, we really need to maintain a pace, we need to maintain that momentum to see that we are able to reach to that target of 100 gigawatt by 2022. Today we keep hearing about a lot of issues in solar sector. I think so there have been, since morning we have been hearing about duty problem in customs duty coming through, anti-dumping duty coming through, safeguard duty coming through. So policy makers are also in a different world, they are trying to do something. But the good part probably we need to see is that when I started working in solar industry, I did it in 2003, which was pretty early, like 14 years back. We were selling the systems at 350 rupees per watt peak. From there today we have come down below, I think so 40 rupees. Volumes have gone up. So something good has been done by policymakers. It's not that everything is bad. Today we have reached to the level of 20 gigawatt cumulative capacity has also been because of the policy decisions which have been taken. So certain decisions may not be benefiting right now, but it doesn't mean that we should not cooperate, collaborate, work together. It is all our shared responsibility to make this mission happen. There are various stakeholders. There are policymakers, there are developers, there are EPC companies, there are O&M companies. And all of us need to play our role as a common vision, as a shared vision and shared responsibility. That is exactly what the entire Nike team did. Yeah, if you see the pictures, these were the team members. There were 25 members who were a part of this team. People or the athletes were the ones only who were running. But there was a team behind the runners. They were sports psychologists, nutritionists, sports doctorates, ground people to prepare the ground for them to run. So there was a plethora of team which was actually managing the show and managing the show for entire 1 year to prepare for the event. That is exactly what we need to have as a shared vision and shared responsibility, that all of us together need to work to see that we achieve the target. The thing was, if you see, these were the three athletes who actually competed, even though there were so many people who were running. The target was to train these three athletes. One is Mr. Kipchoge, Tarsi, and the third one is called Desisa. All of them have been accomplished athletes. Like Kipchoge has won 7 or 8 international marathon races. He is a Rio gold medalist for the marathon. Other two guys have been doing the half marathon and world record holder as well as gold medalist. They're earning in millions as an athlete actually, yeah? But still, they took over the challenge of running and trying to break something which was different. So adoption is a key. Challenges will be there. They went through the grueling session of more than 1 year to prepare for this event actually. So my point is that everything will have its own set of problem. Every stakeholder will see it's a problem, but till the time we all don't adopt it and try to work around it, things will never happen. If we just sit around in the comfort zone, as what Mr. Sunil was also saying, if everybody of us contribute in some way or the other, I think so there are ways and means and possibilities will be created to see that we move ahead onto the solar sector. Last, I think so all of you would be also excited to know what happened actually. On the 5th of May, the race did complete. Out of three athletes, actually, two of them could not consistently maintain that pace and they have to bow out actually, yeah? And only Kipchoge, who is already a world record holder for the Rio gold medalist, actually completed in 2 hours and 23 seconds. So he missed the target only by 23 seconds actually, yeah? But if we really see that all of us work together, all of us work in a tandem, make full-fledged efforts and work towards the goal, I don't think so a target of making 100 gigawatt is impossible. And that's what the rival brand of Nike Adidas says, impossible is nothing. Yeah, and that is what we should all work towards to make this solar mission work. So this was all about my presentation. I'll just brief you about my company, Enerpac. Enerpac is a German headquartered company out of Hamburg. We are a solar IPP as well as an EPC company. We have done close to 2 gigawatt of grid connections. We have our own assets of 1.1 gigawatt on our own books. And we are maintaining close to 1.4 gigawatt of assets worldwide over and above our own vehicles. In India, we have done a couple of marquee projects, including Delhi International Airport, as well as Hyderabad International Airport, as well as a couple of rooftop projects. These are some of our reference clients with whom we keep working on a regular basis. And that's all from my side. I'll be here to take your questions as well as lead to the panel discussions further. Thank you so much.